So this podcast is about easy ways to draw logarithm graphs. I will start off with an example on y equals log x base 3. So I'm going to convert it into the exponential form because it's going to be much easier to fill out this table. So as you can tell, this exponential form gives you values of x in terms of y. So how about we fill out the values of y first, and then fill out the values of x that would give you those values of y. In other words, I'm going to fill out some nice values for y, like negative 2 and negative 1 and 0 and 1 and 2 and maybe 3, and try to figure out what the x values ought to be in order to get these y values. So I'm going to fill in when y is equal to negative 2, x is 3 to the negative 2, which is 1 over 9. So I'm going to fill out a 1 over 9. When y is equal to negative 1, x is equal to 3 to the negative 1, which is 1 over 3, and so on. Now you can basically fill out the rest. You can see the pattern. That should be a 1, 3, 3 squared 9, 3 cubed 27. So let's fill out the graph as well. As you can tell, we have our usual intercept at 1, 0 right here. And so let's put that as 1, 0 right there. And at 3, you step up to a y value of 1. Oh, wrong way, wrong one there. That should have been a 3 right here. And then at 9, you step out to 2. And then at 27, way over here somewhere, you step up to 3. As you can tell, you got to multiply each x value by 3 before you step up on the y by 1. So that's the function. And I really want you to realize this, that this is the opposite of the exponential function. We are multiplying by 3 to step up by 1. Multiplying by 3 to step up by 1. And again, multiplying by 3 to step up on the y by 1. So as soon as you realize that, you will have a much easier way of drawing logarithm graphs. So next, I want you to think about how to draw the logarithm graph for log x base 9. And I want you to just do it in your notes, straight off, no tables, and then check your answer. So again, I want you to think about log x base 9 and try to just sketch the graph directly with what you know about logarithms. Pause me now. Okay, here's how I would think about it. I would say, well, the intercept has to be at 1, 0. So let me plot that in, 1, 0. So that's one point. I've got to move 9 locations down to rise up by 1. And then I've got to move 81 locations, as in 9 times 9, and then it'll move up again by 1. In other words, 9 comma 1, and then 81 comma 2, and so on. And then I've got to divide by 9, as in 1/9, to get to a spot 1 less than 0. So as you can tell, it's pretty easy to draw that graph. And we're done.